So when we work an interview with a leader, we're asking what's the culture that you want, and then what's a practice that you're putting in place to try to get that culture, and how is that working out for you?
This podcast encourages and empowers you to create your own unique real story, develop your own unique real statement, and discover your own unique real self. The power is yours. Good morning, Kimberly Culbertson. Previously episode 1433 of the 12 Minute Convos podcast. It's been just 2 years, 3 months, 18 days, 12 hours, 47 minutes and 53 seconds since we last recorded that conversation. That was then, this is now. Kimberly, how are you doing today?
I am doing good. It feels crazy that it's even been that long.
It does.
It feels like yesterday that we were talking.
Yeah, and your voice, it practically sounds the same, like when I listened. Well, yeah.
Good, I think.
I think so.
Sounds good.
Yeah, thankfully our voice doesn't age the way our body does.
I think my body's getting better.
Well, that's great.
I just turned 40 and I spent my 40th birthday at a climbing gym, climbing the walls.
Well, you're doing the climbing thing as well. Now, just for those that may just be listening to your episode right before our conversation, is your husband. And
right?
This happened a couple of years ago, exactly like this, where your husband came on and then you right after. It must be that you both have something great going on, right? How have things evolved?
We actually speak and podcast together. And so originally we were trying to get you to let us just do it together. And you were like, no, I like one-on-one. And so we just are back-to-back because everything we do, our business is both of us. So from a business perspective, we are a duo.
Yeah. And it started from a relationship perspective, which I subscribe dearly to in terms of meaningful conversations and building relationships. So how have you seen things evolve in your life?
Well, in some ways, we're still doing the same thing, kind of plugging away. Our business was called Creation Curve Leadership, and we found that no one could quite remember it. And so we spent a little bit of time thinking about if we were going to change our name, what would it be? And then a friend of ours said, everybody just calls you Kimberly and Coach. And so we were like, okay, so now it's the same business, but I just go by Kimberly and Coach. And so our Instagram and our website and everything is Kimberly and Coach. But we basically work with teams and corporations and leaders to help rehumanize leadership. So we talk about it in our podcast, which we actually just relaunched a new podcast on Monday. So 3 days ago.
That's good. Congratulations.
Thank you. It's the Kimberly and Coach Show. And it's a little bit shorter format than the podcast that we had when we were interviewed 2+ years ago. So it's around 20 minutes and it really focuses in on a practice of value. So when we work an interview with a leader, we're asking what's the culture that you want? And then what's a practice that you're putting in place to try to get that culture? And how is that working out for you? And so the idea is that somebody could listen to it on the way to work and then walk into work with a practice that they could implement that day and experiment with it themselves. So I'm really excited about it. Same vein of content, but just like a punchier format. Sweet. So it's an exciting time over here.
Yeah, that's great. That's wonderful. Where are you on the Enneagram? Coach was telling us about that and how you're working with churches a bit more with that. Where are you on the Enneagram?
I'm a 7. Ooh. So we are both 7s, which might be why we are a husband and wife duo that still have fun.
Well, we said something on the podcast, or you said it specifically, that you bring the synergy. And I believe that's very important to note in terms of some people. I think there's a fine line between compromise and being synergistic. I'm not sure if synergistic is a word, but we just said it. So it's a word now, right? So yeah,
it is.
How
now
do you do that? How are you able to maintain that level of synergy?
Well, in terms of the Enneagram, we're both 7s, but we have different wings and different subtypes. So if you get really nerdy with the Enneagram, you can have 100 7s. They'll all look different, you know. And the way that Ben approaches business is often really big picture, big vision, and looking for how can we make this new and interesting. And so he likes to kind of be visioning out into the future. And then I'm the person that is a little bit more strategic and how do we get there. And so I'm always kind of running along with the vision, weaving the fabric of what we're doing. And so I tend to see the details more. And so it's nice for me because I can borrow his vision and he can borrow my weaving, so to speak.
Yeah.
And we just create things that we both really enjoy. We're both sevens, which is the enthusiast. And as sevens, we do not like to be bored. So if we get bored, something is probably going to change. Mm. And because we don't like to be bored, nobody else likes to be bored either. But a lot of training is boring. Our training, we really strive to be not boring. You won't be bored.
Mm. That's something we spoke about as well, the difference between importance and urgency. Dig into that and how that affects organizations for us, please.
Well, I think when we spoke about it, we were speaking specifically about our son, who was six, and he just turned nine, which has been, it's a really cool age. He's in third grade, and it's kind of the grade where psychologically you're figuring out who you are, like in terms of like child development. And so it's really neat to see him kind of making choices about who he wants to be. And we just try to keep in mind that with being entrepreneurs and starting a business and running a business, it will take all your time if you let it. And we just know that there's a lot of things that will seem urgent, but we want to make sure that our son enjoys being part of our business and doesn't feel like the business is the thing that always steals us from him. And so we just continue to spend our energy carefully and to invite him into whatever parts that are interesting to him. So since we spoke, he has done some voiceover work.
Sweet.
He has spoken with us at a retreat. Our church was very cool about letting him come up and speak with us. He has his own startup kids business and has taken a product to market, six different markets over the course of the last 2 years. And he has evolved. He has done two different products. And so we just try to include him in the thinking about what kind of life do you want? What should we do to create that life? What can we do together as a team? And obviously there's a ton of it that he can't come to with us and isn't invited into, especially like we do a lot of corporate training. But he always gets to kind of sit down with us as we're planning it. And he sees the slides. And when he asks questions, we turn our face towards him and we talk to him about here's what this means. Yesterday we were training around a church tool called 5Q, and he was asking, well, what are these letters and what do you think I am? And so we just sat down after the group had left and just sat and talked through the whole thing with him, because he had just kind of heard from his bedroom where he was playing a video game. And he came out and he had all these questions. So we just try to make sure that when he wants in, that we open the door as much as we can. Because at the end of the day, we don't want to have a thriving business and a kid who's not sure if he's important to us.
Mm-hmm. It reminds me of that earliest childhood memory. Like when you shared that, you're describing what you're creating based on that inner voice that wants to be treated the way you were treated when your mother, so that you overslept and then you got up and you were hungry. You communicated that to her, and then instead of being quarreled with or get back to bed, right, you were facilitated. The conversation was facilitated, and the impact on that was huge. And now you're doing that for your son. So I just wanted to point that out and how beautiful that is.
Oh, thank you. It is one of my favorite memories with my mom, because it just felt like such a special thing to have dinner in the middle of the night with just my mom. I had a little brother, and so it was rare that my brother and I are only 18 months apart, so we always were together. There's never that one-on-one with my mom. It was rare that that was possible. And so I think at that age, it was just really special to me to have her full attention and do this cool thing, which now looking at it from a seven perspective, I'm like, we get to eat dinner in the middle of the night.
Yeah, let's do it.
Not even any vegetables.
You know, what's cool is from our conversation, I wrote here that listening opens up the gates to wealth. It felt like that was something we were uncovering in our conversation, that the possibility that occurs with listening is that rich. Would you say that's accurate?
Oh, yeah. So much. Actually, in the last 2 years, I also gave a TEDx talk.
Sweet.
And it specifically, thank you. One of the things I talked about in that talk was that people think of team building and relationship in their business world as kind of a fluff topic. Like if we have time and we run out of stuff to do, then maybe we'll do a team building retreat or like a shot in the arm kind of thing. But there's a lot of research on employee engagement, and Gallup puts out this State of the Global Workplace report that talks about how many people are engaged and disengaged and actively disengaged. Really interesting stuff. And their findings find that disengagement costs companies $550 billion a year. $550 billion. And when you think about it, if a person is partially disengaged at work for whatever reason, they are not giving their full percentage of effort. So let's say you're paying them for a whole week, but you're getting like maybe 3 days worth of work or maybe 2 days worth of work. And whenever they can, they're kind of moving away from it for whatever reason. There's various reasons. So if you could grab and capture their engagement through good relational work, then of course the bottom line is going to move. Of course your company is going to make more money. Of course your products is going to be better because people are fully bought into what you're doing. And so a lot of my talk was trying to convince and lay the foundation of this actually really matters so much. It does. Work that absolutely needs to be done in every corporate space if you care about money and your product and quality.
Yeah. Well, it's a great pleasure, my friend, to call and get both of you, right? Both Coach and you, Kimberly, and have a conversation with you, more so to know that you've not given up, that you've continued on the things that bring passion. I'm sure there were the ups and downs on this journey, just like every other journey, but you've not given up. So that is great. More so, thanks for your service to humanity, because as I always point out, this is not something you needed to share with as many people as you are sharing it with. You could have said, okay, it's only corporate, like we'll only do this for the corporate people that are paying, right? But you've decided to find ways so that you can reach out to other people. So for that, well done. In closing, is there anything else you'd like to share with our amazing audience?
Man, you asked me that last time and I felt just as blank. I feel like it's been really fun to talk to you. And I think one thing that your podcast does is it connects people to people you wouldn't necessarily run across. And so those connections, they matter. If you take space to think, what can I learn from this person that I maybe never would have encountered, then there's probably a nugget that will improve your life. So we should listen to each other.
Love that.
That's my closing thought.
Wow, that's super cool. Again, amazing audience, Kimberly Culbertson. You can check them out, Coach and Kimberly. Kimberly, again, a pleasure. I treasure. Thank you for being on What is Inspired by 12 Minute Convos with Angel Jones. This podcast is produced by Pod Edits. Visit podedits.com for professional podcast publishing.